Hello everyone, it's Grandpa Ron here again. Hope you're having a great day. Everybody's well and happy. Over this Christmas, we had a lot of lights in the neighborhood and everything, and around here, a lot of times we go weeks with the kind of overcast skies and all, so I kind of miss seeing the stars. And the other night we actually had a clear night and could look up and see the stars. You know, with the naked eye, you can only see maybe 4,000 stars in the sky, but with the modern telescopes, it's unbelievable, incomprehensible, the number of stars that you can see. And I mean, billions and billions and billions, millions of galaxies, even with the Hubble telescope. So I was thinking, why would God make so many stars? You know, why create all those stars in heaven? And I started to think about that. And before I get to my conclusion, I'll shift gears and talk about some more earthly things. I saw on TV they opened a new section of Walt Disney World, Star Wars Land, and there are a couple of new rides there that I guess the Star Wars folks just came to tears when they saw all the technology involved, how wonderful it was and how great it was, you know. And started to show me how man is like God describes him. We're self-centered and we start to become egotistical. Look what we've done. Another thing I saw on YouTube was these drone shows where they have hundreds of drones with multicolored lights and effects on them that they can pre-program, and they go up in the sky, and I don't have any videos embedded in this, but you can go online and just in YouTube type in drone shows and see these beautiful shows they put on where all these hundreds of drones go up and they can make all kinds of patterns. They can make them look like famous people, the way they arrange them. And against the dark night sky, it's just really beautiful. And you think, boy, and all the technology involved in that, you know, just amazing. Look what man has done, how far we've come to be able to do that. Even the space program. Well, we've been to the moon and quite a few times. We've had men walk on the moon, and now we're going to go to Mars. We've got that all planned out, and now we're putting forth our efforts to put people on Mars. And I guess that is a lot of technological achievement. But that's accumulated knowledge. It's knowledge that man has accumulated over thousands of years. And so we tend to get egotistical. Man is our own solution. We can handle anything. Give us enough time and we'll figure it all out. We'll put a cure to every disease and handle every problem on earth, and look how great we are. But God, in just a spoken word, created the billions and billions of stars and galaxies out there. He just spread the heavens out like a curtain. We can look up and with the aid of telescopes, see all these billions of stars. And it's God saying, yes, man, I created you in my image. You have the capacity to learn. You have the capacity to do some pretty good things. But look what I've done. Look what I've done. you can look into space with the telescopes and look and look and look and go as far as you want to go, and there'll just be more and more and more and more. And in comparison to my creation, what you've done is pretty feeble. And he's right. The magnificence of God is displayed in the heavens above us. And you know, that can be kind of demoralizing, you know, and we look at ourselves as infinitesimal and so small. And David, in some of his Psalms, cried out to God, "What is man? I mean, that you would take notice of him." Because God has done so great and wonderful a thing in creating the entire universe. But God wants us to also remember this. Not that we're just from man's viewpoint, infinitesimal and small. But the Bible says that God created all the stars and he's numbered every one. He's counted them all. And he's named them all. He's named each one, which means each of these billions of stars is unique. But he keeps track of them. He knows what they are. He knows his creation. And he's saying to man, you know, you're small, but I'm a mighty God, and I'm fully capable of dealing with you as an individual. I know your name, Ron, and he knows all of our names. He's able to and fully capable of taking care of us, knowing us and taking care of us. And so I think that's why he made the stars, is to help us to put things in perspective in two ways. One, God is marvelous, wonderful, a great creator, very powerful, and man is weak and small. But number two, God still loves us. He knows us. He cares for us. And if we'll acknowledge that and believe that, then we can go on to the next step, which is eternal salvation, which is to realize, who is this God that actually created all this stuff? Well, the Bible makes it clear that there was the Lord Jesus Christ. He was there with the Father, and the Father planned it all, but Christ did it. He's the one that created this, the universe. And he loves his creation. He loves his creation enough to, even though we don't acknowledge him and we rebel against him, we want to go our own way, he was willing to come and pay the penalty for that. The Bible says the wages of sin, rebellion against God, whether it's passive or active, you know, it's just saying I don't care one way or another is sin. But the wages of that is death. And because God is holy, and he can't be in the presence of sin. But Christ came to this earth, was born as a man, lived a perfect life, so that he would be an appropriate sacrifice in our place for our sin. And if we'll accept that Jesus was God, that he came, died for our sins, but he was validated as God by being raised from the dead and is now in heaven with the Father, that we can have eternal life. So yeah, that's what I was thinking. Why so many stars? It's because God knew that as time goes by, man will become more arrogant and more arrogant and more arrogant and more arrogant. But no matter how arrogant we become, if we look back and see what God has done, we see that our efforts are pretty pathetic in comparison. So I hope you like this perspective on how many stars there are. And when you look up at the sky at night, just thank Almighty God that not only does He know each one of His unique stars, but He knows you too, and He knows me. And He cares for us and has a plan for us. And believe that. Believe in His Son. Have eternal life. Well, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.